As I stand here, tapping away at my laptop, working on this script, stood at the kitchen worktop on board my humble narrowboat, Abel's Ark, I glance up and take in the now near completely empty surroundings. I try and take a mental photograph of this moment, and with it try and take in the smell of the burning wood and the feel and the sounds of the fireplace crackling away. Every time a towpath walker goes by, I eagerly look towards the door and await a knock, as I'm here today waiting for another prospective buyer to come and view my humble narrowboat home of the past 4 years or so. There's a near indescribable mixture and number of thoughts and feelings and emotions that rise and fall in my mind. There's the sadness at letting go and bringing a final end to the era of Dan and narrowboat Abel's Ark. There's excitement and joy and a little bit of apprehension about finally being able to go and look for my next boat and what the future of boat life is going to look like, and even what my future boat is going to look like. And equally, there's just that dread of the whole selling a boat process. I know from my time selling my previous boat that it's not always as straightforward and simple a process as it should be. I think I can sum it up by saying, imagine having to rely on goodwill, taking people at their word, honesty and personal responsibility in the year 2023. But it's all fun and games, and just the excuse to stand around talking about boats with somebody is something that I certainly enjoy and take to, perhaps a little bit too well. Anyway, there is an added element of thought and concern and complexity this time, as I know that right at this very moment of me being stood here on a grey day on a boat, my girlfriend Sam...
Put your arm in bed.
...is currently doing multiple trips, filling a car with items to take to a charity shop or to the skip, as she prepares to finally downsize to a much smaller property after a year-long process of her own. This downsizing is not just a downsizing from house to house, but a first step towards ultimately downsizing all the way to a narrowboat. And so where over recent years I've been indecisive and I've been making spur-of-the-moment decisions whether I'm going to live on one boat, sell a boat, buy another boat, whether I'm going to quickly dart back and rent somewhere out on dry land for a few months, all of these decisions have been absolutely fine because it's only been me that's been affected directly by them. Whereas now, trying to line up a future where we potentially both live on board, I'd certainly say that some of my decisions have been a little more thoughtful and methodical. So that's at least one positive I can take away, that I might actually now at age 35 start making grown-up sensible decisions. Let's not hold our breaths on that with too much hope though. It seems appropriate that so many of the days that I've met up with prospective buyers for the Ark have been these overcast, cloudy, mild, generally grey days. If they'd have been sunny days, I feel it would almost disrespect the fond memories I have on board this boat and suggest that getting rid of her was this magical new era beginning in the sun. Equally, they haven't been these dark, wet, stormy days, which would potentially suggest bad omens for selling the Ark and what was in store for the future. So I'm happy to stick with grey. A grey mixture of emotions, a grey mixture of plans for the future, and a grey sky above that is not particularly warm, is not particularly cold, but like the third bowl of porridge, is just right.